Interesting. We'll have to move fast. Well, well. A domestic servant in Marteau's estate has a lead on the Persephonite and its mysterious point of origin.
So, boss, is that Marteau Industries tip your agent dug up any good, or what?
It's quite promising. Our new source is sick of doing Marteau's dirty laundry. She's decided to air it instead.
She can tell us where the Persephonite is.
She didn't know anything about Persephonite, but she can lead us to where it's made all the same. Let me explain. Recall Marteau's crossroads network. Beacons, relays, transmat pads. They all require precise coordinates. Instantly transmitting a living person across the globe has a narrow margin of error. Every time someone enters or exits the crossroads, the coordinates are logged in a company archive, where our new friend's ex-fiance now works. She impressed upon me that Marteau prefers his domestics to be single, and the young man preferred a promotion.
Yeah, poor girl. But since Marteau probably uses the crossroads to get to his foundry, you're thinking the coordinates to the place will be in that archive.
Exactly.
Okay, but it won't be filed under greatest secrets, my.
Unfortunately not. Agents, you'll need to grab all of Marteau's transmaterialization logs. We can comb through the data back here at the hideout. Wherever he travels to the most, that's where we'll begin our search for the Persephonite.
The mesmerizing Celestine. A knife-throwing act in Berlin, right? No. Berlin.
Berlin, madam. And I saw you perform at the Winter Garden in 29.
Ah, yes. I remember that show. You have an extraordinary memory.
An occultist entering the city without my knowledge could have meant my death.
Of course, of course. The stage was only your cover, not your calling. Isn't that right?
It began as a cover, but some days perhaps it was more.
Maybe performance was your true calling all along. Would you like a reading? This isn't generosity. You look like a woman with a fascinating star chart.
Thank you, madame, but no. I know my end. Details would only make it harder.
Senorita Rodriguez. You are not cut from the same cloth as the others in this group.
What do you mean, Mr. Locke?
Well, you would have made a fine lamplighter even back in the times of yore. Unlike most of the others, you are not selfish, loutish, or low of character.
Mr. Locke, every person here has risked their life to save an uncaring world from a horrible fate. And they have done it, knowing they wouldn't have been let in the servant's door of the old Lamplighters League.
I meant no offense.
These are my people, Mr. Locke. And if I don't fit in yet, then I shall work harder at being selfish, loutish, and low.
Couldn't keep away, could you?
Stay sharp. You know what's at stake.
need something special from me?
Always fair prices here.
Ha ha! What are we working on today?
What'll it be?
You wish to guide the hand of fate?